here for my man, P. Scott, having a show in the night, man. It's a VIP hour. Typically, we don't pop out this early, but, you know, we want to support that brother, man. Support us. Nothing but much love for him, man. He's dope, man. Can't wait to check out what he got. You know, it's going to be some dope work.
Good to see you.
We did this piece with Caesar and I did that with
Which one? Which one's
right here? With Brownie and Pete.
From a while back. You look familiar too, bro.
Of course.
Yeah, you are.
That's the good part of the detail.
We're a little early, you know what I'm saying? But the setup is super, super dope. There's three floors. Then the first floor that has all the Pete Scott merch, games, fun. Then you go to the second level. You got, you got Jack Daniels set up. They got the music set up. They got the models. They got, you know, some giveaways, some nice takeaways. Then the third floor, you actually got the missing pieces that we've been looking for. So you gotta go and hit each floor to find the actual treasure, which is, you know, pretty much found at the top floor, the last floor. And it's a really dope set with some really, really dope pieces, some great work. Peace, God. Without him, I love what you're doing, man.
So, you know, Follow the Dream is something that me and my boys came up with, kind of, sort of. Like, I came up with the initial concept, and then we kind of, like, elaborated on it. For me, like, what Follow the Dream means is, like, following your intuition, following, you know, that inner passion, whatever you're passionate about, whatever you're talking about, like, to really lock in and hone in on that, you know what I mean? And also tapping into, you know, this that spiritual, you know, realm, you know what I'm saying? Or that higher power. And for me, you know, when I put it together, it was like, you know, first of all, the crane kind of represents for me origami. Origami is something I did heavy as a kid. I was all into origami. You know, Buddha's always kind of been my thing too, so I kind of confused both of them. But like once I started like, so this piece, actually, the reason why I wanted to stand over here, this piece was actually in a different series. This was in the series that was on a rooftop at Joy District. And this is what started the idea of Follow the Crane, because of the way the Buddha and the crane, you know what I'm saying, and the vibe that it gave us. So, you know, I was like, it's only right to kind of put this back in, you know, in play. But yeah, to tie it back into the play. But like, you know, that's what the whole concept of this show is about. You know, just following your inner intuition, you know what I'm saying?
And it's so dope too, man. The whole setup, bro. Each floor got something different to it. It's a different experience for each level. I'm like, we go to so many shows that don't be curated right. You know what I'm saying? Like, bro, the way this put together is laid out right. Perfect, bro. And then the missing posters going up.
So they actually found them, or is it like a gimmick? Or?
Because it was a situation in Miami.
This show was supposed to be in Miami when y'all had that show.
Yeah.
And you know, they failed to ship it. You know, and in fact, they lost. It wasn't just that they failed to ship it. They were like, we don't know where it's at. And that was heartbreaking for me. I'm like, man, it's my first show in Basel. And y'all talking about you lost my work. Like, I was like upside down, bro. But by following my train, you know, and people kind of like, yo, look, bro, you know what this show is about. You got to live up to that. You can't. Like, because I was ready to throw the towel in, bro. I was like, nah, I'm good. Like, this is over. Let's just have fun. I was like, yo, let's go see everybody else stuff. But now that, you know, inside of me, I was just like, you know what, man, I got to really truly follow that train. And that's what I did. And we turned out to do it, you know, we figured out a way to recover. And we did a pretty dope show. And the way we did it was with the missing posters. We was like, you know what we're going to do? We're just going to create a bunch of missing posters and make that the body of work. Like, make that the exhibit. And then that way, it's like, people are like, man, is this the exhibit for real? Like, and, you know, and it kind of fucked with people's minds. It was like one of those situations. And people appreciated it. You know, we still had a lot of entertainment. Voice was performing, judges were killing it. And then we had like a live, interactive paint, mix, and mingle type thing. And people really, you know, they enjoyed that shit. But yeah, man, this was like, that's why it's the loss of time. You know, because it was one loss.
You
had an opportunity
to throw the towel in and you made something right out of it. That's what the champions do, bro.
That's up.
Doing that, and you putting on, it's like, I love what you're doing too, cause like, you from here, but you're not even really from, you know what I'm saying? You represent multiple cities, bro, but you represent so hard, bro, putting on to make an odd city look better. Like, man, how you gonna love that? You know what I'm saying? Appreciate that. That's what we're doing, bro. Like, good details, really, bro. That's a platform for to help serve dope artists doing dope things. You know what I'm saying? And you're gonna do that, bro. Congratulations on the show, bro.
Appreciate you, bro.
I'm about to answer 1,000%, bro. Whatever I can do, whatever we can do. 100, bro, whatever you do, bro. It meant a lot when you showed up down there, bro. So yeah. I'm like, oh, yeah, I fucking love this guy, bro. Whatever he need, I'm here.
Yeah.
I was already there, but I'm all
the way. Yeah. 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 I love what you're doing, too, bro. And, maybe one day I'll be getting good details.
Come on, man. One day, bro.
One day I'll be getting good details. I was like, no.